how to use a brake fluid tester. The test point is your brake master cylinder. You'll need to be able to dip your tester into the cylinder, so remove the cap first. Of course, if you can draw some fluid from one of the calipers, or even each caliper, into a dry glass container, then you can test the fluid from those points as well. It's likely that the water content at the caliper end of the system will be higher than it is at the master cylinder end of the system. So the results you get from this test should always be taken as being on the optimistic side. First, put your battery in your tester, making sure that you've got it the right way around, and then put the cover on. I've actually lost the cover to this one, so I normally put a piece of tape over that. And then most testers turn on by pressing the button at the top. Make sure that the green battery light, or 0% light, comes on. That tells you that the battery is good. Imagine that this shot glass is the top of your master cylinder reservoir. I've syringed a little bit of brake fluid out of my reservoir and put it into this clean, dry shot glass so that you can better see what we're doing. But you would normally do this in your master cylinder or into a similar receptacle if you've been able to draw some off from your calipers. Switch your tester on, make sure that the 0% battery light comes on, and then dip the prongs into the fluid to their full depth and note which light comes on. You'll see that here my red 3% light has come on. That means I've got at least 3% moisture in my brake fluid in the reservoir, which is telling me that it's time for me to do a brake fluid flush, which I know is about correct because it was just over 3 years that I last did one. In terms of interpreting the results, you'll almost certainly find, even with fresh brake fluid, that the 1% light will probably come on. After a year or two, you might find that the 2% light comes on. But eventually, like in my case, 3 to 4 years, the 3% light will come on. Now, the 3% light was red. You'll have seen that the 1 and 2% light were orange, which means it's safe to proceed. The 3% light was red. That's because when the fluid gets 3% moisture in it, it's time for change. Above 3%, there is a 4% light on this tester, but above 3%, the properties of the fluid are seriously degraded. So it won't be long before I'm doing a brake fluid flush. Top your reservoir up while you've got the bonnet open and the cap off. Don't forget to put the cap back on your reservoir. And it really is that easy. One of these is only about a fiver. I'll link to some in the description. If you got value out of this video, please consider supporting the channel in some way. Maybe buy something from the links in descriptions of my videos. And I shall see you next time.